With the first pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Markelle Fultz from the University of Washington.
A few moments later,
Markelle Fultz is on his way to your Orlando Magic.
What?
From being the first overall pick in the 2017 NBA Draft to now being considered one of the biggest busts in NBA history, today I'd like to take a look at Markelle Fultz's career and analyze his game from the ups to the downs. But before we get into today's video, I'd like to bring something up. Only a very small percentage of people that watch our videos are actually subscribed, so if you enjoy this content and want to see more like it, make sure to drop a like and leave a sub. When the 76ers ended up with a 28-54 record in the 2016 NBA season, it left them with the third pick in the 2017 NBA Draft. But the third pick just merely wasn't good enough for them, as they had their eyes on Washington guard Markelle Fultz. At the time, the Celtics had the first pick via the Nets from the trade that sent Paul Pierce, Kevin Garnett, and Jason Terry for Gerald Wallace and four first-round picks. So the 76ers did what any other team would do. They traded for the pick. So when the 76ers drafted Fultz, a lot of people thought he was the third star to finally make this team a title contender. And keep in mind, the Boston Celtics went on to draft Jason Tatum with the third pick in the draft. And don't get me wrong, I thought the Sixers made the right choice here too, until I saw the October 9th preseason game where Markelle Fultz took his first free throw. And it looked like this.
Play. That was the result of what been.
Later on, he explained that this form was due to shoulder soreness that he'd been dealing with for a while. And then on October 29th, 2017, Fultz was declared out indefinitely. And this injury lasted all the way until March 26th of 2018, and the Sixers let him finish out the 10 last regular season games of the 2018 season, where he averaged 7.5 points, 3.4 rebounds, and 4.5 assists. On not too bad of shooting spreads, but not amazing. And of course, after missing that much time due to injury, Fultz wasn't really in their playoff plan. And then on September 20th of 2018, Markelle Fultz claimed that the jumper that they drafted him for was back and even better. And then the start of the 2018 season, Markelle Fultz was playing odd minutes. He was in the starting lineup after all, but it didn't really feel like it. He went on to start for 15 consecutive games. And then just like it seemed when he was getting the minutes he deserved, he was then benched for 4 games. And then a day later, Fultz was ruled out for the foreseeable future and had appointments to go see a shoulder surgeon. At that point, it just always seemed like Fultz's name was in the headlines. Whether it was for his hitched jump shot, or for him being injured. And then on December 4th, 2018, a new diagnosis came to light. Fultz was diagnosed with neurogenic thoracic outlet syndrome, and it was said that he could miss anywhere from 3 to 6 weeks. And as the timeline goes, nothing really happens until February 7th of 2019. And that's when the 76ers sent Markelle Fultz to the Orlando Magic for Jonathan Simmons and a first and second round pick. Up until that point, Fultz had only played 19 games that season, due to the same shoulder injury. And this is the point where it gets interesting, as Markelle Fultz starts to revive his career. Fultz's debut for the Magic was in a regular season game against the Cleveland Cavaliers, and he showed out big time, as he finished with 12 points, 6 assists, and a pair of steals. And he showed Magic fans that he still has some potential. And as the season went on, Markelle Fultz really made a name for himself in Orlando, proving that they weren't wrong for trading for him. A game that I'd like to talk about is Fultz's second career triple-double against the Los Angeles Lakers. In this game, Fultz really showed what he was drafted number one for. He scored 21 points, 11 rebounds, and 10 assists, and he even hit a game-clinching layup on LeBron James himself. And the Magic clinched the dub 119-118 that night, beating the best team in the Western Conference. I guess the point that I'm trying to make here is Fultz truly has revived his career, and people need to learn to see that, as he's averaging 12-5-3 for the season, while averaging 25% from the three-point line and 47% from the field. Let's hope that his game keeps coming back to him and that he's able to have a successful career in Orlando. Let me know what you guys think of Fultz in the comments. And remember, if you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, please drop a like and leave a sub. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next one.